I just want to share just a few words about the ministry of the seasoned saints that Brother and Sister Shaw have so gallantly led us over the past, I guess, at least 20 years, if not longer. Our seasoned saints are a vital part of the membership at Eastside. Proverbs 16:31 tells us, the silver-haired head is a crown of glory. It is found in the way, if it is found in the way of righteousness. Proverbs 20:29 states, the glory of young men is their strength, and the splendor of old men is their gray head. In these passages, the emphasis is upon the splendor and honor that one gains from maturing in age. Solomon's point is that with the old age, one becomes honorable and more splendid because of the wisdom and knowledge they have gained from living. This is befitting of Walter and Barbara Shaw. Old age in that of itself is not enough, but rather in life that is seasoned by living for the Lord and by following his word. That is befitting for Walter and Barbara Shaw. And I especially like the fact that they're seasoned saints, seasoned with love, that they're seasoned with patience. They're seasoned with kindness. A life lived for the Lord will result not only in righteousness, but will produce wisdom that can be passed on from generation to generation. This is befitting of Walter and Barbara Shaw. The ministry is in place to minister our seasoned saints or 50 plus members, allowing them to utilize their talents as well as to serve as a social outlet. It enables the seasoned saints the opportunity to provide spiritual wisdom and guidance to our younger brothers and sisters. This is befitting for Walter and Barbara Shaw. The leaders of the seasoned saint must be faithful, active members of the congregation. They must have a working knowledge of the Word of God, and they must know how to work well with others. How befitting for Barbara and Walter Shaw. Brother Shaw and Sister Shaw has taken the seasoned saints on all types of adventures, such as tailgate parties, movie nights, live plays, that's in Branson, Arkansas, Oktoberfest in Fredericksburg. He took us on a trip to Amarillo. Holiday feast. We went to Waco on the train to visit the train station, a historical train station in Waco, Texas. We went on a tour of old Austin, to see parts of Austin that a lot of us probably don't know exist. Musicals, remember Temptations? We visited nursing homes, community care packages, and those good old fish fries. Now, Brother Shaw can fry some fish. We had some great fish fries over at Brother Shaw's. If you want this same type of adventure, get involved with the seasoned saints. But Brother Shaw, Sister Shaw, we're thanking y'all for your leadership that you're still exemplifying with the seasoned saints. And we want to just spend this day showing gratitude towards you. Now, next on the program, we have a song by Connor, your grandson. You good to go? Okay. Tech team, you good to go? Now, come on then, Brother Connor. We're gonna give it to you. But Brother Connor's a student at Texas State. He's known for his theatrical and musical abilities. And we're stepping out on faith. His mama talking about it all the time. So Brother Connor, it's all yours. No problem.
Thank you. Must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. Beautiful face without a name for so long, a beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything I would like to be, I could fly high. Appeared to go unnoticed, but I've got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. Of course I know it, that I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. I could fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. Did I ever tell you you're my hero? You're everything, everything I wish I could be. Oh, oh, and I could fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings.
beautiful, beautiful song. Well done, and very, very befitting for a grandson, for the life that has been impacted by Brother and Sister Shaw. A couple of things, we're gonna wrap it up here. We just wanna present the Shaws with the plaque and some flowers. And then we'll have a few words by Brother Shaw, a few words by Brother Williams, and we'll close out with the word of prayer. And I'll bring this to him. I'm going to read it, then I'll give it to Brother Shaw in a second. This plaque reads this: with love and appreciation to Brother Walter Shaw and Sister Barbara Shaw, for your years of dedicated service and leadership, presented by the Seasoned Saints 50 Plus Ministry, Church of Christ at Eastside, Austin, Texas, presented this day of Sunday, November 12th, 2023. The Shaw spirit of love and commitment is expressed and demonstrated in Philippians 2, 3 through 4. Let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than himself. Let each of you look out not only to his own interests, but also for the interests of others. Very befitting, Sister Shaw, Brother Shaw, and your love and dedication, commitment, not only to the Lord's body, but to the Seasoned Saints. Your leadership is so deeply, deeply appreciated. We present this to you on behalf of Eastside Church of Christ and the Seasoned Saints Ministry.
Sister Shaw, we didn't forget you. I looked up the word Shaw. I took your letters and I decided I would just do some research. And the letter said, for the S, supportive, self-confident, snazzy, steadfast, sincere, sweet, straightforward. Humble is for the H, honest, heartfelt, helpful, hardworking, and always happy. The A, astute, awe-inspiring, authentic, accountable. For W, I came up with welcome, welcoming, always welcome us at your home, heartwarming, wise, willing, well-read, well-versed, and well-traveled. And then I looked up, that's the last word I found was wonderful. That's what you both are, just wonderful. Amen. So I said I would do this. I said, you know, steadfast means when you are sure about what you are doing, and you know that it is right, and you refuse to give up. You never have given up on the Seasoned Saints. When we had five present, three present, two present, it didn't matter. You said, well, two or three are gathered. We had a meeting, and we went on. We never canceled a meeting. We always had them. So I said, today I wanted to give you your flowers while you let live so that you can see the beauty that they bring. We wanted to speak kind words to you while you can hear them, so you can feel the comfort that they bring. We just want you to know that we love you, and we wanted to honor you today just to say how much we really, really appreciate you both. And the flowers are for Sister Shaw.
Brother Shaw, do you want to say a couple words, or I can give you the mic if you don't want to stand? We're so grateful to have his family here with us as well. He might want to introduce them in his own way. Brother Shaw.
I'm overwhelmed. I had wind this, but I didn't know it was going to happen.
No, we...
You know, I thank Brother Russell.
Turn around and face it.
This is my oldest son.
Oh, no.
And he's I'm 84. Mm-hmm, 80 more. My boss now. And they're doing a good job.
Amen.
Knows the Bible.
Yes.
And is not afraid to give it out. He's a good one. Well, I was born in 1936. Eastside was born 1933. So you may say that I was born in Eastside. I had no say about it. My dad was the second minister at Eastside. And when he would go to Lockhart to help build that a congregation up there, he would take me. We never missed a Sunday. And I look forward to it because he would let me drive. Never had a wreck. We tried to let my mother drive, but all of a sudden on the highway, she made a big stop. And I said, "Mom, why are we stopping here? If you see that stop sign over there, it says stop." I said, "Yeah, that's for the people coming that way." I appreciate it. I got a lot of stuff I could tell you. But maybe one day I will. Don't have much time. But I'd like to talk to you about Eastside. Brother William, I've been here. I know what came in and out. And what's in now is never going to come out, not the way the others did. Brother William is a true preacher. True. Sometimes he reminds me of my dad. But thanks for your support.
I am thankful that I have been in this congregation and you have seen me when I was all over the auditorium. Now, I'm still at this in this congregation. Legs are still long, but they don't want to move like they used to move. So I ask that, and to tell you how much I appreciate your thoughtfulness, because what I've done with this man that was here in this congregation before I even knew and thought about a Church of Christ, because I was in another congregation. But my mother always told me, "You're going to have to cooperate with Walter." And that was my daddy's name, too. Didn't plan that. So I was engulfed with Walters in my life, and I love them all. But this man has stayed with me the longest. We've been together through thick and thin. And it wasn't anything we could be embarrassed about. It was a time that was what I wanted to do. I married a man that I was learning about him and he was learning about me. And we wanted to be together. And as of June of last year, we've been together 61 years. Yes. And I'm thankful that I was with this man, not a collection of numbers. Okay? And that he brought me, eventually, I changed my membership of being a Baptist because I was baptized as a young girl and I fainted after I came out of the water. And I worshiped in the Baptist church because that was my family on both sides, my mother and father. But then I left for college and had a scholarship here in Austin, Texas. And guess what?
God had a plan.
He was coming back from being in the military because his mother had passed. And he was walking over there to that cemetery on the one that on airport every day because he couldn't let go of what had happened. So he told his dad, "Daddy, I'm going to leave and go get in the military." So he was already in college. I didn't know him. I hadn't arrived. And when I became a freshman, he was coming back to school at Houston Tillerson. And that's where it started. Yes.
God had a plan.
Yes. God had a plan for me, and I'm glad he stuck by me. Because I have not let go. As long as I've been in his life and he's been in my life. And we look what we've done. And, yes. And they have done the same thing. Yes. When I was baptized on 14th and a half, my daughter turned around and said, "I'm going to do that too, Mommy." And I looked at her and smiled and nodded my head. And she did. And you know, whoever the leader is, the next parent's going to come behind. And I don't know if my other son is here, but my grandchildren have done so because they're parents. So I tried to do everything I saw my family do and be chastised. And my children are doing the same thing that their parents saw us do. Amen. And I want to thank you for just doing what you do all the time. We have been blessed. You all who are new, you have truly been blessed because Brother Williams was where I started and he's still with us. Amen. And we thank you.
All right. Thank you all so very much. I guess I found my father and mother. You know, when she said 61 years, you said 61 years or 62? How many did you say? 61 years. Lord have mercy. So I was just 5 years old when you guys got married. Isn't that something? He said the same thing. That is tremendous. I just want to say to all of the family, God bless you all. You have a wonderful mother and father and whatever they may be to you, grandmother and grandfather. I've known Brother Sister Shaw, well, ever since I've been here. And just wonderful people. I have so many stories I could tell you that I won't do that. Okay, down in Houston. Yes, wonderful. But I know you've been sitting a long time, so I won't be very long, but I do want to just say a few words. When I think about the two of you, and I know it's honoring both of you, and the word consistent came to mind. And the definition for consistent, steadfast adherence to the same principles or the same course or the same form. So when you talk about steadfastness, you're talking about being resolute and dutiful and unwavering. You've shown that in your life. You've shown that in your marriage life. You've shown that in your Christianity. And you've been an example. All of us can look at you and say, what a beautiful example of a husband and wife, of a father and mother, grandparents, of Christians. And that's what God wanted. You have grown old gracefully. You know, sometimes people say they want to grow old gracefully. Well, you can't start when you get old. Amen. You got to do that while you're young. And that's what you've done. When I think about growing old gracefully, I think about what you've done is you've added those Christian graces to your life that Peter said we ought to add. And that's manifested in your life. Peter said in 2 Peter 1:5-8, but also for this very reason, given all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to your virtue knowledge, and to knowledge self-control, and to self-control perseverance, and to perseverance godliness, and to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness love. And you have shown that. You know, you've driven the youth all over with your bus. We had laughter about that. And you know, I've seen Brother and Sister Shaw over the years talking to one another, and Sister Shaw would say, that Walter, I don't know what I'm going to do with him. But she loved her Walter. And Brother Shaw just kind of shakes his head and just go right on. And so that's a beautiful example of Christians and what they do. It doesn't never mean you don't have challenges, but you showed that you can handle those challenges with Christ and in a Christ-like manner. Y'all are blessed. I will close with this. As I thought about your life, I had to think about the Apostle Paul. And one of the most endearing images I have of Paul, which is also very emotional to me when I think about it. Paul, of course, met with the elders at the church at Ephesus in the 20th chapter of the book of Acts, and he was headed to Jerusalem. And, you know, they were trying to convince him not to go because they knew that his life would be in jeopardy. But I like what Paul said. Paul said, and see now, I go bound in the Spirit to Jerusalem, not knowing the things that will happen to me, except that the Holy Spirit testifies in every city, saying that chains and tribulations await me. But then he says, but none of these things move me. And you have not let anything move you. You have been steadfast. No matter what storms you had to encounter in life, in your marriage, in your family, in the church, none of those things have moved you. So I thought about that, and he says, nor do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may finish my race with joy. And that's what you're doing. You're still running. You haven't finished yet. Amen. And we're going to keep praying for you to run as long as you can, as long as God wants you to. But you're doing it with joy. You're not complaining. You're not grumbling and griping. You're still smiling. And I appreciate that so very much. We love you, and we appreciate you for all you've done. God bless you. You've been a joy, and you're still a joy.
Thank you. I'm here for the clothing prayer. Most kind and gracious Father, we come humbly before your throne of grace. Thank you for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, we come thanking you for our brother and sister Shaw and the job that they did for us. Father, we come asking that as the season saints grow, we keep them in mind and keep their message in mind. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.